Hello, ladies, gents, everything between without, and welcome back to more Sam and Max. Season 3, aka The Devil's Playhouse, episode 1. Shit, what's it called? The Penal Zone. Yeah, that's it. Penal Zone. Right in the Penal Zone.
Hello, and welcome to a bold new reimagining of the Computer Obsolescence Prevention Society.
Minus Bluster Blaster.
Yeah.
Chippy.
What are you doing in our car?
I said you guys could hang out in our car until you found your own place, but it's been months now.
You have been randomly selected to enjoy a free trial on XL at no cost to you.
Oh, shit. I'm so excited about this.
You guys should keep an eye on General Skunk Ape. We're pretty sure he's evil.
That guy is a total heatsink. A real motherboard.
We thought everybody else liked him except for us.
His so-called advanced technology is going to make thousands of hard-working computers and robots lose their jobs.
When buying technology, look for the Made on Earth label.
The thing that bothers me is that they changed his voice. His voice was really the best, you know, Kurtz.
What's this business about a free trial?
You have selected to hear more about the Crimetron XL.
Oh no.
In a world where thugs and supervillains rule the streets, only the most technologically advanced crime stoppers will emerge victorious.
Submit clues gathered from your investigations and we will analyze the living hell out of them.
Oh, awesome.
Let's try out the Crimetron right now.
We're sorry, the Crimetron XL may not yet be available in some areas.
We are still recruiting members for the COPS.
For the last time, we are not letting your Japanese robot dog into this group.
We talked about this. That dog is straight up creepy.
A Japanese robot dog. Yes, indeed. It's one of the creepiest things I've ever heard of.
What happened to that Bluster Blaster machine you used to hang out with?
He has traveled with user Bosco to Las Vegas, Nevada.
Why?
What's an outdated arcade machine supposed to do in Vegas? He doesn't even have any money!
Bluster Blaster received a generous workers' compensation settlement upon his termination from Pimplicar.
We cannot comment while litigation is pending.
So basically, he sued them? Interesting.
How are you guys supposed to help us fight crime?
Yeah, you're not even as powerful as a cell phone.
Max, that was completely uncalled for.
With my 16MHZ of raw power, I am able to analyze data at speeds rivaling the most advanced pocket calculators.
Hmm. And what do you do?
I'm a functional telephone, and that's about it.
Useful, what can I say?
Talking to you guys is great and all, but could we have our car back?
If you'd like to drive somewhere, use the handy city map contained in the glove box.
Hey Sam, isn't our car still possessed by demons?
It is not so bad as long as you do not try to run the air conditioner.
Oh yeah, it is possessed by demons, I almost forgot.
See ya, cops.
End of line.
Indeed. Oh look, some jumper cables. Let's take them because they may be useful.
Why do we have jumper cables? Neither of us knows how to use them.
It's simple, Sam. The red cable goes on the right nipple, and the black cable clamps to
Neither of us knows how to use them legally, Max.
Oh, Max. Never change. Never, ever change. So, it's right there, Bosco Tech Labs. Let's not go there yet. We still have work to do here. Let's see.
I hope they finish the repair work on our building soon. I miss taking showers.
We could just give ourselves tongue baths like cats and flight attendants do.
Well, okay, I guess. Just be careful around the back of my neck. That's where I'm most prone to tie rash.
That is pretty damn, oh look, a pigeon. This pigeon kind of reminds me of the one we saw in the Hit the Road. I think.
Did you remember to feed the parking meter, Max?
I slaved all day over a hot stove for it, and do I hear one word of thanks?
Because he's an inanimate object, you douche.
It's been months and they still haven't sealed up this crack. Somebody should do something about it.
I say we all wear gray ribbons to raise crack awareness.
Crack awareness.
It's a good thing Sybil packed all her junk into these boxes for safekeeping.
Oh, look.
And I'm especially glad we didn't put it in a secure, environmentally regulated storage facility like she asked us to.
Yeah, this way's a lot cheaper, and everybody gets to enjoy it.
Indeed. What do we have up across the street? Nothing. Okay, let's talk to Super Bowl, or let's talk to Max first, actually.
I sure hope the planet doesn't fall for General Skunk Ape's plan, whatever it is.
Well, he is pretty charismatic, Sam. And he's from space, which is a plus. But you're the only hairy, overweight, domineering control freak I need, Sam.
Gee, thanks, Max. I think.
You think, eh?
Do you remember the what to do in case of alien invasion checklist, little buddy?
Oh, I know this! 1. Interrogate the alien leader. 2. Liberate any horrific experimental creatures trapped on their spaceship.
And?
Oh, 3. Trick them into believing that cat litter is the official Earth currency.
Then sit back and watch hilarity ensue. Good work, Max.
Foolproof. I'm impressed with their alien backup plans.
Sybil sent us a postcard. She and the giant stone head of Abraham Lincoln are still on their extended honeymoon.
And you said their marriage wouldn't last.
Actually, I said it was a violation of the laws of nature and most major religions. The city looks a lot different from what I remember.
It's the new mayor and his Man Up, New York! It's a city, not a freaking daycare center campaign!
His inauguration was the most action-packed in years, though.
He wore a necklace made from human fingers!
Holy crap. I wonder who the mayor was, who the mayor of New York was when this was being made. Probably Bloomberg.
I hope they finish the repair work on our building soon. I miss taking shower.
We could just...
Well... I'm surprised and disappointed that you managed to stay president this long.
Yeah, that sudden, unexplained outbreak of bubonic plague really brought the nation together for my re-election.
That reminds me. Where's Jimmy Two Teeth and all his rat pals?
Damnedest thing! They suddenly came into a lot of money from an anonymous benefactor.
That, children, is called a false flag. Ah, Max, you're so devious.
I wonder what it'd be like to live on another planet.
Probably a lot like this one, but bouncier and more methane rich.
I don't need to go to another planet for a methane rich environment as long as I've got you, pal.
That's really sweet and obvious, Sam.
Indeed it is. The most obvious joke, actually. Shame on you, Sam.
It feels good to be on a case again.
Now, is it really a case if we don't have a client and no one's paying us?
The client is Justice, Max, and Justice is blind and frugal.
Really? Isn't Justice a glutton?
These psychic powers of yours are pretty neat.
I guess. It's just too bad I didn't have them on prom night.
Cheer up, pal. Just think of all the destruction you can cause at the class reunion.
Cool.
Keep watching the skies, Max.
I'll shoot if they try anything funny.
I still can't believe Bosco left town without saying goodbye. Now we'll have to go out into the city when we want to buy stuff.
I don't mind. I embrace change.
That's hobos, Max. You embrace hobos.
Right. What did I say?
Bosco Tech Labs. Visit our new location.
Oh, so Mama Bosco's too good to haunt our street anymore?
Apparently so.
This is kind of a bad neighborhood to be a ghost. All the best cemeteries are on the other side of town.
My side of town. Hey, Super Bowl.
Hello, sir. Mr. President.
Song and dance routine.
President, you are the ruler of this planet?
Oh no, I'm just President of the United States. We're only one of many United Nations working together
to
achieve...
Sir. You can speak freely.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm in charge pretty much.
Indeed.
Perfect. Just the one I wanted to see.
Keep the hands where we can see him, pal.
But of course. I have come to your pitiful, beautiful world for a peaceful exchange of technology. All the wonders of the galaxy, yours.
Indeed.
What's the catch?
No catch. All I ask in return is your help while my research assistants search for an artifact of interest to my people.
Huh, interesting. So, your shifty tone implies that you are hiding something, sir.
Just wondering, how much do you pay for security on a ship like that?
Security?
You know, laser grids, explosive time locks, that kind of thing.
We're just curious.
My spaceship and the wonders aboard it are open to all the feeble peoples of Earth.
It's no fun when they don't put up a fight!
Indeed, it's not.
So, we can just walk right on your spaceship whenever we want?
Of course. The miracles of my technology are welcome to everyone, especially to your planet's mole people.
What? Mole people? You're interested in mole people? You, sir, are a rarity.
What's this about an artifact?
It is the eyes of Yog-Sogoth. One of hundreds of magical toys scattered throughout the galaxy by the Great Comet.
It's believed to give the holder the power to see the future.
What a coincidence! I was just...
He was just saying how he wished he could see the future, so he and I would stop showing up to work wearing the same thing.
It gets pretty awkward.
Indeed, it does.
So, about this artifact.
Yes, you have found it?
Not as far as you know, but just for fun, why is it so important to you?
It's a legendary treasure, said to give the wielder the power to predict his enemy's every movement, manipulate the economies and governments of weaker worlds, avoid death, find complex solutions to puzzles using unconventional combinations of everyday items, and crush anyone who stands in his way!
But the puzzle thing intrigues me.
That's all just a myth. I would simply give it away to my nephew. In Canada.
A likely story, and one I've heard before. And you seem trustworthy. Let's believe him, Max.
What's the story behind your whole Mole Man fixation?
It's no fixation. General Skunkape is a friend to all creatures of the galaxy. From the greatest ape to the tiniest, most insignificant and pitiable Mole Man.
Hey, we know the most insignificant and pitiable mole man.
Do you know?
Every planet I visit, all of the local mole people are invited to ride my fantastic gamma beam to a wonderful off-world vacation they'll never forget. I don't kill them.
I'm pretty sure you do.
Where are these fabulous off-world vacations exactly?
Why, any planet you can imagine.
Pluto?
That's not a planet, Max.
The planet of the nubile Amazon priestesses bathing in rivers of chocolate and toffee?
Sure. Why not?
Amazons in chocolate and toffee. Too bad they hate men, so you know. Although they may not hate men. In which case, you know, awesome sauce.
What are you doing here, Agent Superball?
As you know, sirs, when you appointed me Secretary of the Posterior, that placed me in command of the Department of Homeworld Security.
I didn't know we had one of those. Did you, Max?
Heck if I know! As soon as they gave me a button that shoots ballistic missiles and a hotline to Mila Jovovich, I lost interest in everything else!
Well, I investigate visitations from aliens, abductions, violations of the time stream, lost continents, myth and legends, that kind of thing.
Oh, so basically what we've been dealing with for the last two seasons, eh?
What's the Homeworld Security threat level, Superball?
It's currently hovering between Candy Apple and Fire Engine Red, sir. I'll keep you updated.
Fire Engine Red. That seems serious.
You're not from around here, are you?
Guilty. You could tell by the accent, right? No, I have traveled from a planet hundreds of light years away from your own. It was once a beautiful, swampy and muggy world. The air dancing with swarms of mosquitoes. the stillness of the night punctuated only by the mewling of infants and the drunken revelries of toothless secessionists. Its name would be impossible for your earth tongues to pronounce, but my people know it as Pensacola.
That seems awfully familiar.
So you're planning to just find your magic toy and leave the planet peacefully, right?
The Earth's Chamber of Commerce has a selection of coupons for discounted dining and entertainment during your stay.
Find my toy and leave? Of course not!
Stay frosty, Max. This is the part where he loses it and rips his mask off or eats a live mouse or something.
I'll get my video camera.
I would never leave without sharing the technology of my world with your backward but fascinating people.
Oh god, could you be any more freaking condescending, dude?
Does the general want a banana?
I see. Because I resemble your Earth gorillas, you assume I want a banana. I'm glad to see that Earthlings are still so charmingly racist.
Relax, buddy. We're just making sure you're getting enough potassium.
And the Skoon Cop is also a race baiter. Fuck off.
All right, we'll let you know if we find that artifact.
After clearing it through the Department of Homeworld Security first, just a formality.
Go in peace.
And you go in pieces. Screw you. Oh, nothing new. Fine.
See you, Max.
Keep in touch! Whee!
Well, I guess it's nothing else for it. Let's go and explore the ship. Wait, what do we have here? The case, suspects, Max's powers. Screw it. I want to see stuff with this thing.
Future vision.
What can I see with this? Oh, the ship. Oh crap. Oh man, that doesn't look good at all.
Max, no, not the Chrysler building.
That sounds fun. I can hardly wait.
Oh man.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Why the fuck are you saying yes over and over again, goddammit? I think that's it for the trinket. And whatever. I want to see something else. Max, come over here, please. Can we see a Super Bowl? No, we cannot. Apparently the phone is gonna ring soon. Cool.
Gee, little buddy. Here in 2109, our street looks pretty much the same as it did 100 years ago.
Keep moving, Earthling! Emperor Skunkape II has demanded tribute!
You used to be so much cooler, Max.
Holy crap! Oh man, look! It's a chicken!
See you wherever that is, then, my love.
Alright. Ship. Time to do some exploring of our own.
It's General Skunk Ape's horrible spaceship. Good likeness.
Yes. Yes. Enter the belly of the beast. It won't hurt at all.
This place looks eerily familiar. Check it out, Max. The control center for invaders from distant stars.
Yeah. Alien spaceship. Seen it. I just want to get to the part where I have those sweet psychic powers.
Do you now? Okay, what do we have up here?
We just need our friend the brain to hook you up and... Oh no, he's dead!
Didn't he look more moist in the future?
Yeah, he did.
We've got to find some way to wake him up so he can explain what's going on.
Oh, poor brain. I knew thee well.
Step aside, ladies! Big winner coming through!
Okay.
Congratulations.
Hey, pal, we want to ask you...
I've been listening to suits like you for too long already. You can dig your own tunnels now, whilst I enjoy an all-expenses-paid off-world vacation. So long, suckers!
Wow. Poor guy. He is pretty much dead. Oh.
And that is why we're doing a staycation this year.
Indeed. What did he have on him, I wonder? Oh, helmet. Great.
Weird. There's a hard hat and some kind of vacation ticket.
All the personal effects confiscated from our fuel resources are collected and donated to various intergalactic Mole Man charities.
What a nice gesture. We should leave it for when that Mole Man gets back, Sam.
I think he went to live on a farm to play with other Mole Men.
Oh! Check if he left his wallet.
No such luck.
Barry didn't have a wallet. Poor guy.
How do you suppose we bring our alien brain friend back to life?
I'm sure you'll figure out something eventually.
I don't have that kind of patience, little buddy.
What do you want, Sam? It's not like I can see the Oh, wait.
Oh, wait indeed.
Keep watching the skies, Mac.
Future vision.
Alright. So, we have the brain.
You did it, Sam and Max. You awakened me from the sleep of 100 deaths. How did you do it?
Well, that's encouraging.
So, how did we do it?
I don't know. We haven't done it yet. I know. What if you use that future vision on me?
Let's see. Where the hell are you? There we go.
You did it, Sam and Max. You awakened me from the sleep of 100 deaths. How did you do it?
Easy peasy. All it took was Stinky's demon broth and Mama Bosco's futuristic power core. Well, you heard the mean little buddy. We've got to find some demon broth and Mama Bosco's futuristic power core.
Indeed. What else can we see around here?
Congratulations.
Ah, poor guy. He will be killed soon enough.
Hey,
apparently.
It's all my stuff.
That's it. Well, guys, I guess that's where we ended for today. See you next time. Goodbye.